think the fact that a single cell can become an entire organism, whether it's a person or a cat, and how that process happens, I find is one of the most fascinating questions in science. When I was in high school, I decided that I wanted to be a medical doctor. When I got rejected from med school, it was a very difficult time, and I felt like a failure. But it turned out to be one of the best things that ever happened to me because it led me here today. I study the early development of neurons in the embryo. There's been some research that showed that overactivation of the immune system in the pregnant mother, more specifically in mothers who've had severe infections during the late stages of their pregnancy, increases the chances of their baby having autism spectrum disorder or schizophrenia. So what our work is trying to determine is how the activation of the immune system in the embryo is causing developmental defects in the neurons. One of the main reasons why we use zebrafish for looking at this problem is that they develop externally and they're completely transparent during the early stages. So we can image the entire brain in vivo, or we can image single cells over and over several days in a row to really see how these cells develop. One of the main reasons why I chose science as my career is that I really love to learn new things. I think my grandmother was very instrumental in fostering my need to learn new things. She was always encouraging me to be curious and make discoveries. I'm always looking for new opportunities to learn. I watch Jeopardy every day. I don't remember actually ever being zebrafish questions on Jeopardy, but science questions, me and my husband, we do pretty good. It's a little cooler now to be a scientist than it was a few decades ago.